There's a place in your house where it's cool to chill, get some me time, or even cook a meal. It's your kitchen, mofo, ain't no time to slack, so just grab yourself a penny and let's work that ass. If you're scared of this place, ain't no need to bother, just lay down your weapons and pick up another. Hi guys, how's it going? Welcome to my Virgin Kitchen. I'm really excited because today I'm making arguably the best chips slash fries in the world ever. It's a recipe called thrice cooked chips because you cook the chips three times, once, twice, thrice. I don't know, it's like that song, once, twice, three times a lady. Maybe it should have been called once, twice, thrice times a lady. Meh, that wouldn't have worked. Anyway, it's by a British chef called Heston Blumenthal, who does these amazing type recipes. Goes a bit scientific and crazy sometimes. Looks a little bit like this. Yeah, so there's only one way that I can try and help myself try and make these chips is by trying to look like him, my friends. And instead of plastic surgery, I'm going to use a swim cap, glasses and a white t-shirt. So let's go. Right, that's better. I'm looking a little bit more like him, although if you're watching, I do very much apologise, Heston. Anyhow, this is all we need, apparently. Got ourselves some groundnut oil. Amazing. Apparently, it's really, really good for chips. It's nice and mild. Uh-huh. Charlotte potatoes, which are all sort of small and waxy and lush. In fact, these are supposed to be very good for making chips too. Some salt. Obviously, not going to use all of that. That is a gigantic bag of salt. Pan of water. Tray, and also I've got myself a deep fat fryer, which is going to make it a lok safer than trying to like fry things in a wok like I did before, okay? Unfortunately, to counteract the safety element of having an actual fryer now, I've got these glasses on, which unfortunately, I don't know if you can see through them. Can you see through that? It's like really, really blurry, so I can't really see what I'm doing, so I might have to put them on my... might have to put them on top of my swim cap when I'm doing the serious stuff. Anyhow, let's get going. First thing we're going to do is cut up and peel our potatoes and make them into like funky chip slice things, about a centimetre by a centimetre. Let's go. Right, so there's the potatoes out of the bag. First of all, I'm going to peel them. Right here then, guys, so they are all nice and peeled. Check that out. All nice and smooth, huh? Loving it. What I'm going to do is use that gigantic knife, cut them into rectangle shapes, and then cut them into slices to make the chip shapes themselves, okay? Try and keep them all the same size, and we'll see how we get on. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. So they're all nice and cut up into chippy shapes. You just want to jump in and put it right in your mouth right now, don't you? Ah, but you can't, okay? Grab yourself a colander like this and put them all in there as soon as you can. Let's go. Brilliant. So they're all in there. What we're going to do is grab them, put them under the tap. And what we're doing here is running under cold water to wash all the starch off of the potatoes, okay? So keep doing that. I'm going to leave that actually running, okay? You need to do it for a good couple of minutes. Ooh, that is a cold tap. Leave that there. What I've also got, just to show you, is my pan is on to heat there. We're bringing that to boil slowly. Once that's done, the starch is washed off these potatoes. We're going to dunk them in there for 10 minutes to soften. That is stage one of the thrice cooked chips. Ugh, my hand's wet. Cool. Right guys, my water's bubbling away there. What we're going to do, I've just literally taken these chips away from the cold tap, just literally plonk them straight in there like so, okay, so get them all in. Okay, yep, so they're in there again. As you can see, the temperature just dropped a bit. So what we're going to do is bring the heat back up till it simmers and then leave it to simmer for 10 minutes. If you let it boil, apparently, they're just going to like start to tear apart. So you want them to cook to the point where you can stick a knife in, nice and soft, and then we'll take them out with a little spoon onto some kitchen towel and then in the fridge. Crazy, huh? Crazy. In the meanwhile, I've also got my deep fat fryer machine and put the oil in there. So it's just sat in there. Can you see that? How shiny that is? Mmm. Healthy-tastic. So let's give it 10 minutes. Let these chips cook. Whoa. Right, guys. That's actually just been under 10 minutes. About 8 minutes to be exact. And I stuck a fork in it and it went through nice and soft. So I'm going to get them off the heat and very gently with a slotted spoon like this, lift them into there. Okay? We don't want to damage them. Righty-ho, so I've put the chips onto a nice baking tray like that, away from the colander, and let them cool down, because they were obviously still hot. I'm going to plonk them in my fridge. Cha-ching. They're going to basically go in there. There's no time scale on that until they're hard. Oh, look at that. It's Phoebe's feet. Anyhow, we're just going to leave them there, and I'll let you know the exact time scale that takes. So they've got to go hard. In the meantime, I'm going to get my fat oil thing up to 130 degrees in there. So yeah, we've got a little bit of time on our hands, people. Let's party. Woo! Right here then guys, I've just got them from the fridge and they are nice and cold, ha ha ha. and also very firm again. What I've got is the fryer up to the 130 degrees and the green light is on, which tells me it's ready to go. Well, that's what the manual said. Anyhow, let's get the chips in the little basket and then we'll dunk them. Let's go. Kapow. Right, here we go. Let's lift it up and sit it in there. Wow. Can you hear that?
I was kind of expecting it to go everywhere, but it's actually quite a low heat there, the temperature it's at.
So apparently we leave them in there so they start to sort of discolour a little bit. We don't want them to go brown, we want them to go slightly golden, okay? So we keep an eye on it for 5 minutes. Wicked times. Okay, so about 2 minutes in, and that is looking better, my friends. That is the sort of scene I was expecting to see.
Wow, I'm keeping my eye on this, and let's keep going.
Right then, guys, that has been 5 minutes, and we're looking for a drier appearance to the chips and a slight change in colour, and check that out. They are looking kind of dry, almost dull, in fact. So, let's get them out of there, be very, very careful, and sit them on our kitchen towel, like so. And I'm not going to walk along here, boom, and knock that out. I'm going to be very, very careful. I'm going to be a sensible Heston. Well, Heston in training anyway, hit. Anyway, they're going to sit there for a minute, let them cool down, probably dab them with a little bit of that extra kitchen towel. Then I'm going to sit them back on this tray. So next time you'll see me, well, these chips will be back on that tray. Let's go. Right, guys, so I've plonked those back on the tray. They're getting quite used to that place and they've cooled down sufficiently. The smell in here, by the way, is incredible. It's almost like I'm sat in a chip shop fryer. It is ode to chips right now in this kitchen. Anyhow, let's pick these up and take them on that familiar journey back in the fridge. And again, we're just going to cool them till they're hardened. Last time took about 8 minutes or so. So let's give it 8 minutes or so and then we'll get them out, fry them again, and they should be ready. I'm so excited. Yeah. Right then, guys, so they're out of the fridge. Took 10 minutes if you're interested for that leg of the cooling. Cha-ching, all ready to go. Put them in the basket in there for a good 8 to 10 minutes till they're golden brown. That will be the final leg of our thrice-legged journey of cooking chips slash fries. If you're American, fries. Oh my God, like you call them chips. They're like crisps. We call them chips over here, people. Chips, okay? Anyway, they are going in there. Okay, guys, in they go for the 10 minutes. Cha-ching. Now, see, they're not making the noise straight away because they're cold. That's why, yeah. Anyway, I'm going to keep my eye on those till they're golden brown. I'm excited. Wow. Okay, guys, we're about 6 minutes in. And if I can just show you that, you can start to see they are beginning to brown. So we're going to carry on with that. Got some more kitchen towel ready and a little bowl that I'm going to serve it in. Kind of funky. Although in Britain, we always have them in newspaper. I'm not going to do that because I don't really want to get food poisoning today. Anyhow, let's keep going. Right here then, guys, hopefully you can see they're nice and golden brown now. I've actually given it an extra 2 minutes because it tells you to be a little bit patient. Oh, there goes my buzzer. You want to make sure this, even though it's golden brown, I'm thinking, they're ready. You want to make sure they're nice and crispy on the outside. So leave them as long as you can until they go blacky kind of colour. But nice and golden brown and you're loving it. Let's go on the kitchen towel. Right, guys, I'm not sure if you can see the colour on that. Let me get a little bit closer. Wow, they are nice and golden brown, and they arguably look like the best chips I've ever made. Okay, so I'm going with this. Let's get them in the dish. Fantastic. So hopefully you're picking up the golden colour a little bit more now. What I'm going to do is just sprinkle some salt on there. Fantastic. Let's serve it up now and see what it tastes like. Right, let's have a go then, people. I'm going to pick this one up. Check how golden brown it is. All good, huh? Let's go for this. Oh, wow. That is amazing. Yeah, another one, hang on a minute. Really crispy outside, soft in the middle. Mmm, kind of like sort of like a kinky sweet taste somewhere. Loving it. Heston, my friend, you have done amazing. This recipe works. If I can make that, absolutely anyone in the world can. Have a go for yourself. Let me know how you get on and I will see you again on the next video. Cheers.
High five!